Good afternoon, everyone. This is Shubham Roy from HackSyux, and today we are going to learn about the different techniques of hacking particular machines. Like, for instance, we have already known about what Nmap is and what Nikto is. So once you've covered with this web enumeration and system enumeration and information gathering, what you need to do is you need to look into the system, the particular services in the system, and hack them. So this is the video from which we start actually hacking into services. So the first thing you need to do is you need to set up your lab for these demonstration purposes. Now, the first thing you need to do here in Kali Linux is you need to install VirtualBox. Right, for those who have followed our Windows tutorials, like in the first one, the first video, I have told you how to install VirtualBox or virtual machine in Kali, so in Windows. So now, to install that in Kali Linux, the first thing you need to do is you need to use apt. Now, what is apt? Apt is advanced packaging tool. Now, apt helps you find different things that's there in the Debian repositories. There is a etc sources.lst file which has different repositories your Linux distribution, your Kali Linux distribution looks into to install packages. Now, for instance, I want to install a package called VirtualBox. Now, I do not know what are the different packages there. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to apt cache and I'm going to search for VirtualBox. Now, as you see, this command searches the apt cache and returns me VirtualBox, which is a solution, x86, that is 32-bit virtualization solution. So, now what? How I install this is I'll go to apt-get install VirtualBox. Now, since I've already installed VirtualBox, it says that VirtualBox is already the newest version, and that is why it's not installing. But for your institution, it's going to install VirtualBox. And once VirtualBox is installed, you have to open VirtualBox, go to New, click on name, say Metasploitable, and Linux, Ubuntu x64. Let this be normal. The 1024 MB is good enough. Use an existing virtual hard disk file. Now, once you use an existing virtual hard disk file, then you need to search which virtual hard disk file to use. I searched inside this HackSyux Metasploitable, and there is a VMDK virtual machine disk, VMDK, which I'll select, which I selected and I created. So once you create this, once you select that disk and click on create, it's gonna be created. And it's going to be created, and you're going to have something like this, Metasploitable running. You have to click on, you'll have Metasploitable box there in the list, and you'll click on it, and this will run. So, once Metasploitable loads up for the first time, it'll show you a lot of different logs and but after that, it's going to give a Metasploitable login. Now, msfadmin is the default username and password. Once you go inside, msfadmin. Yeah. So msfadmin and msfadmin is the username and the password. So once you log into it, you log into the Metasploitable distribution. So there you see msfadmin Metasploitable. Now, for instance, I want to look into the. Oh, I'll have to change the screen resolution for it to come to full screen, but whatever, it's still understandable, I guess. So msfadmin into Metasploitable, I've logged in. Now the first thing I need to see is his IP address. So I'll go ifconfig, and here I have an IP address of 10.2.0.1. Now if you'll notice something, that if I open host and if I go to my computer's IP address, I would see that my IP address is 192.168.0.3. So this IP address and this IP address is not reachable. So I cannot find this with the help of my computer. For doing that, I need to first close this virtual machine, close its default settings, and then let's go to power off. Let's click on OK. And then I need to go to VirtualBox again. So as you see, I need to either make a host-only adapter or a bridge adapter in order for this to work. Now, how would I do that? Like I've showed you in the Windows tutorials, all you need to do is go to settings, of this virtual machine, go to advanced, network. Network, this is a NAT adapter. Now, NAT is network address translation. I talked about this when we were looking into the first video. So what this does is it masks your IP address. It masks your IP address behind a different, behind your computer's IP address. So whatever my public IP address is, every traffic I send through this Metasploitable machine is passing through that. But that is not what I want. I want this to be a different bridged adapter or into a host-only adapter. So once I go into a host-only adapter and do VirtualBox net 0. So I do that and I click on OK. Okay? Then I start this virtual machine. Once I start this virtual machine, I would again have to look into ifconfig, and you would know that VirtualBox net 0 is a different interface that's loaded here. Now, if you look into this interface, you would see that the IP address is 192.168.156.1. Now, once this Metasploitable window opens up again, I would show you that the IP address of this machine will also be with this suffix, 192.168.56 suffix. So why is that? That is because these are in the same network. Now, those aware of networking might understand that the net mask and the inet address would actually tell you which IP address is in the network or not. So msfadmin and ifconfig. Now you see, I see 192.168.56.101. So this is in the same network. How will I be very, very sure of that? To be very sure that I am able to reach that particular machine over the network, I am going to use ping. So if ping sends me a reply, ping sends me a reply from this host telling me that this host is alive. So ping is basically a way to send a message to a particular computer in your network and see if it's connected to you or not. Now that Metasploitable is connected to me over the network, I have been able to use this IP address and look into the different services and different ways Metasploitable works. It is just a computer in my network. So now what you have to do is you have to simply minimize this, and you can cut this and go to this site where you will have the Metasploitable 2 exploitability guide. So before looking into this exploitable guide, the first thing you need to do, like any other machine in the system, is enumerate. So to enumerate, I would use nmap. Nmap minus vv minus a minus d4 192.168.56.101. So nmap is going to start and enumerate the different services. Like you see, there are so many different ports that open in Metasploitable, and all of them has different services that we can look upon, test and work with. Like port 80 tells you that there is a internet server. So I can simply go to 192.168.56.101 from my machine, and it will directly take me to the Metasploitable 2, because this is hosting a web server, and by default your web browser always goes into port 80 or 443 depending on HTTP or HTTPS. So this is also web hacking, which I'll show you in the few tutorials next, but for right now, understand that once we have loaded this machine, we have set up our lab and we have scanned our machine. So we have seen that there's anonymous login allowed, there's FTP, there's SSH, then there is a bind server, there's an Apache hosted here, the web server, there's Samba, Linux Samba. Samba is a way of sharing messages, SMB with Windows, right? So it is a workgroup Samba that's there. Let's open. Then there is RMI registry, Metasploitable root shell, and there is a lot of things like this, Metasploitable bind shell, bind root shell. So this means NetMap has searched this particular address and it found a bind root shell here. So these are the different services like Pro FTPD 13.1. Different services that are hosted here. We will look into how to access and how to attack each of these services and understand further of how hacking is actually carried. But once you have done all these scans, you would find so much information about the different services that are running in Metasploitable. Now, that's all for this video. We are going to look into hacking these services and finally hacking into Metasploitable in the next few tutorials. another thing I would want to show you is 192.168.101.1524. There you see. So, bind shell and what is the reverse shell is something which we'll look into the next few tutorials. But for now, understand that what this scan told me is that 1524 has an open bind shell, a Metasploitable root shell that's open here. So what I simply did is I simply connected using netcat to this particular port, the port it was set using map. So once I connected to this port, I found that there was a root Metasploitable shell. That is, root is the most powerful user in Metasploitable in any Linux system. So I have a root shell that's just open out of carelessness or out of just, this is just for a demonstration purpose. So once I connect to this, I would directly have a root shell. Now I am the most powerful user in the Metasploitable system, and I can check that by typing who am I, and it returns root. So I'll have basically every kind of power I want. Like I am the most powerful user, so I can even look to etc shadow. So there you see, that's the different shadow and the hashes of the user. Now how to find these hashes, how to attack these hashes are all those things which you will learn in the next tutorials. For now, understand that scanning with Netasploit and using netcat to connect to the different ports for all purposes is the main basic thing which you need to do. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.